Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and Android 11 Beta 3 was released yesterday to developers and beta testers, and this is the final version, or the final beta, or the release candidate that should be basically finalized so that it would be the same as what comes out to the public in a few weeks to a month or so, according to Google. Now, this particular version was fairly large, and you'll see here it was the first time I installed it on this device, but it was 1.73 gigabytes, and it's available for the Pixel 2, Pixel 2 XL, 3, 3XL, 3A, 3AXL, Pixel 4, and 4XL that I have here. Now, technically, it should work on the Pixel 4A as well that I have here, and some Samsung devices. But if you have a different manufacturer other than a Google phone, Samsung, Oppo, OnePlus, those companies, they have to push out those particular updates. So they should have them, but it's up to them to push those out. So hopefully you see those already or see those soon. Now, the build number on this particular update you can see is RPB3.200720.005. And the first change is they've changed sort of how they show the build number in the notification drawer here. So at the top, you'll see it's cut off a little bit. And then we have a divider line with our media player at the top. And this is one of the first changes with Beta 3. So we have our media player here in our quick settings, and we can stack this up to five of them. So we can swipe between YouTube, as you can see here, or music, or whatever else you have that's allowed to play media on the phone, and you should see it here. You can also swipe away media alerts now, and then there's another setting in here as well. So if we swipe this over, tap on the little setting icon, you'll see that we have a new update or a new option that says hide player when the media session has ended. The player allows you to resume a session from the expanded quick settings panel. So you could turn this on if you want, turn it off, whatever you like, but that's a new option that's showing up. Now the power menu has been changed again. Now they've changed this a few times throughout the beta. So if we press and hold power, you'll see at the top, we have emergency power and bug report for the betas. And then I have quick access to my home cameras and things like that, which is nice. But if we press on power, you'll see we have a square menu of, or two squares that make a rectangle of power off and restart. So we've got these in sort of a square now. And then if we tap off of this, it may not be arranged the same way for you if you're running beta 3, depending on if you have this home section there, it may or may not be there. So you may have power to the right, just depending on what you have on your display. Now with this version, Android has finally added their Easter egg. So let's take a look at that. We'll go into our settings here. And you can see I had Pixel Buds previously connected. Some of these are changing around a lot, but it's showing you what you previously had, what you're connected to. But let's go down to our Easter egg here. So if we go to About Phone, then we scroll down, tap on Android 11, then at the top, tap on Android version 11, keep tapping, and now we have our Easter egg. And it's a dial that we can turn up to 11. So we can keep turning, it won't let me here. We can turn it back and forth, and then you turn it back and you've got an 11. So you can literally turn it up to 11, which is kind of clever. And then you saw a little cat down here at the bottom, and there's another Easter egg as well. So if we go back home, press and hold the power button, and we've got different options here. We now can have cats. So if we go to add a control, we can add a control or edit a control, tap on see other apps. Under see other apps, we've got cat controls. So if we tap on cat controls, let's have a water bubbler and a food bowl. That's good enough. We'll hit save. And now if we tap on home, we've got cat controls. So we can swipe up for the water bubbler and we can tap to refill the water bowl or the food bowl rather. And then if we go home, sometimes the cats will have conversations and show up in your notifications. So it's pretty interesting to have that little Easter egg in there, but the cats are back. So that's something that's new. Now, if you like emoji, those have been updated for Unicode as well. So if you go into your messenger, whatever you're using, and you go to your emoji, you should now have over 100 new emoji in here. So there's over 100 new emoji and different skin types and skin colors. So there are a ton of new ones throughout here. Of course, if you use a lot of those, you'll appreciate that, but they continually update them to comply with Unicode standards, and they've added a bunch of them to do that. Now there's two more changes in this particular update. So again, if we go to settings and then we go to our developer options, so we'll go to system, go to advanced, go to developer options if you have that turned on, and then we're going to scroll way down until we see smooth display. Now you can search for this. It makes it a lot easier. So I'll just do that, smooth display. And as you can see, there's smooth display. This forces the display on the Pixel 4 and 4 XL into 90 Hertz. Of course, this is going to reduce the actual battery overall because it won't be variable, but you have the option to force the display onto 90 Hertz again. So it's nice that that's back. And then finally, you may have already seen it in my search here. There are now exposure notifications. Now, the nice thing is it says to turn on the exposure notifications, install a participating app. It's off by default and there's no way to turn it on unless you have an app that wants to actually use it. So not only do you have to install the app, you have to verify that app, allow the app, and then turn this on to allow this as well. So it's sort of a double layer of protection in turning that on. So you'll have that option in the future if you have exposure notifications and apps that comply with this sort of API built in. And that's everything new as compared to beta 2 and beta 1. There are a bunch of other changes as well, which I'll cover when it finally comes out, if there's a lot of different changes. But overall, I've been using this for a day and it seems fairly smooth. Everything's been nice and fast. It's been very stable, at least over the day or so. Apps are opening quickly. Everything from the camera, can snap a picture quickly. Everything seems to respond very quickly, and I haven't had any issues as far as that goes. So I've been using it for YouTube as well as social media, and it just seems to work fast and like you would expect. Now, I would expect a feature drop as well next month, hopefully with this version as well. I'm not sure if it will be in addition to this, but supposedly there will be a feature drop in September. As far as overall battery, I wouldn't expect any increases at this point with this particular device. I think it's as good as it's going to get, but in general, it's been lasting me a couple days as I've been using it as my secondary device, but overall it seems to be doing pretty well. You'll see this says 3 days left. So I tend to put it on the Pixel stand at night. So that seems to keep it topped off and I haven't had any issues, but in general, it performs very well. And I think it'll be a good update. It won't be a huge game changing update compared to Android 10, but Android 11 is a nice update. And if you want to try the beta, I don't see a reason not to, as long as you don't mind having to wipe the phone later on. Now, if you've found anything else that I haven't mentioned, please let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.